Right, now we're going to talk about outerwear for festivals. Right, so you can opt for Oasis sort of chic, and that's with the parka jacket. Now I came across a bargain in the sales at Gap. The key to this is that it's got a hood, which is very useful. One, to hide your hair when it's looking disgusting and greasy, and two, because you know English weather, it's not very reliable at best of times, so that is great. And it also packs up very small into your bag. But if it's really cold, you'll have to layer this with jumpers and t-shirts underneath, because it won't keep you that warm. Right, two. I don't know if you're the same as me, but when I was younger, this was the bane of my life, the pack mat. Every time I'd go out, my mum would say, let's put the pack mat in your bag, knowing full well that I wouldn't wear it if she wasn't there, because it was so embarrassing. But anyway, I got myself a Kangol one, which is still not that sexy, but, you know, it covers you up, keeps you dry, and once again, packs up into a very small space that you can carry around with you all day, should the weather deteriorate. Then, right, I'm sure you've heard that sheepskin is very in this autumn winter, and it's already coming in slowly during the summer. So team it with another trend of denim, and you've got the sheepskin denim jacket. Now this is quite cosy, but yet again, it won't keep you dry, so maybe you could have this and then layer a waterproof mac over the top. That's another option. Right, and the final option, which is the option I generally go for, is the rock and roll leather jacket. Now, it could be a bit boring, so I try and accessorise it with some badges, and it doesn't always do the job in terms of warmth, so I often layer it with my American Power hoodie, which is kind of cool. So, yeah. Right, next we're going to be talking about headgear. Now, I'm not one of the girly girls that wear the beautiful floral scarves around their head, sort of like hippie style. I go for more practicality, so that's what I'm going to concentrate a bit more on today. So, option one. Ooh, the trusty beanie. Now, I spend a lot of time in these beanies, mainly because I can't be bothered to look after this mess of a hair. But this is great for, right, day two, you're generally, your hair's a bit greasy. By day four, it's just revolting. So you want to do whatever you can to cover it up, and it's a quick and easy way to do that. And it's quite nice and warm when it gets a bit chilly at night. So beanies, always a winner. I usually head to H&M, this one's an H&M one, or actually Army Surplus stores are really good as well, so give that a go. Right, if you've been treated to some nice weather and want to shield yourself from the sun, obviously you can't go wrong with a nice straw hat. Now as you can see though, as this one demonstrates quite well, they do tend to get a bit crushed, either in the mosh pits or just in your bag or whatever, so they don't really last very long, and people like to steal them for some reason, so you often come away from festival without the hat. But anyway, still a good look. Next, something that was seen a lot this winter. Right, so maybe not the sexiest look, but really cozy and snug. And when the weather is being unreliable, it's really good, particularly when you're sleeping in a tent or in a van or whatever. It's really nice and cozy. Right. You'll see a lot of lads in particular sporting the truck hat. Now I'm not even going to put this on because I know how ridiculous I look in it, but it seems to work for some of the guys, so that's another option as well. You can get these a lot of vintage stores, actually, places like Rocket, Beyond Retro, they have a lot of cool trucker hats. Or you can, if you're a bit more fashion conscious, there's all sorts of trilbies, bowler hats, all sorts of hats like that. I got this one, I think about £7 from a high street store. It's quite comfortable. Doesn't keep you very warm, but this is more of a fashion look than, you know, practicality. So there's some options for you on the hat front. Another option, which is one favoured by a lot of the people into extreme sports and surfing and stuff like that, is the woolly, well, I don't even know what it's called, but one of these hats. Now it keeps your ears nice and warm, yet again, maybe not the hottest look, but it seems to work for all those guys, they look pretty cool in it. And I got mine from a place called Kazan, and they do a great selection of knitted hats and gloves and all sorts of things, so go and check them out. Right, so now I'm going to be talking about shoes for festivals. Right, so for years I just opted for the Willy. You know, it seemed practical, it was easy. But that I wasn't as fashion conscious then, so maybe it was just like, oh, whatever. But these days I like to think a bit more about my look. So I went to TK Maxx. I found these little beauties. So very small heels, so you've got the comfort factor that wellies give you. Blacks pretty much go with everything, but the key thing, look how soft the leather is. It's so much more comfortable than a welly, but does the same job, so definite winner with these, and only 20 quid. Really recently I treated myself to these little beauties, which I took with me to download a NAS festival. See, key feature here, the zip, so you don't have to do all the lacing all the time, that's a bit laborious. The only problem with these is I left the first pair that I bought in the taxi home from download, so I had to fork out again for them, which was a tad annoying, but I love them, so it's fine. These look great with, you know, denim shorts, denim skirt, with your leggings, anything really. So yeah, really versatile, useful, and great just when you're not at festivals as well. I think they'll be great for winter as well once festival season's over. You'll see a lot of people daring to just bring trainers, which obviously when you in wet weather is not very practical, could lead to trench foot and stinky, sweaty, smelly feet. But you'll see a lot of people sporting the retro high tops that are everywhere at the moment, getting from Reebok or Puma or anything. They're pretty cool, but like I said, if it's muddy they're going to end up ruined, so on your head be it. My major tip would be bring flip-flops. Now it's not always going to be practical with British weather, but at the end of the weekend when you feel tired, blistered, just feeling pretty rank, to take off your sweaty socks and your shoes and air your feet and just put on flip-flops, it's just glory basically. So I just went to Primark, got myself some flip-flops for £4, really compact as well, so you can just slide them at the side pockets of your bag, your rucksack, and then for the journey home being comfort. So yeah, that's the top tip for festivals.